Okay, in this video, we're going to take a look at one of our basic integration rules called the sum and difference rule. And here's what it handles. It handles when you have an integrand that has more than one term or expression that's being added or subtracted together. So this rule is used all the time for like polynomials, for instance. If you have something like 3x squared plus 7x minus 1, on and on and on, where you have terms added and subtracted. Well, thank goodness that there's no special weird rule or anything like this. The sum and difference rule is extremely straightforward. All it says is that you simply have to integrate the first expression. So we'll integrate f of x dx, and then plus or minus the integral of, g of x. And we can just do these on a term by term basis, and that's fantastic, because usually f and g independently are usually somewhat easier. So here's just a real simple example. This is where this rule is often used, like I said, with a polynomial. If you have the integral of 3x squared plus 6x minus 7, we're assuming here that you already know some of the other rules. So if you don't know exactly what I'm doing here, you might want to refer to some other videos. But this first term, if we integrate just that, 3 would be a tag-along constant multiple rule, if you want to find another video. X squared is the power rule and would lead to x cubed over 3. And so the 3s cancel, and the integral of 3x squared would simply be x cubed. That's the antiderivative of 3x squared. The sum and difference rule says that we can simply add the integral of this expression and then subtract the integral of this expression. The integral of 6x would be 3x squared. Again, I'm skipping some of the other steps. That's not really the purpose of this video. 7, the integral of 7, that's the constant rule. That's minus 7x. And because this is an indefinite integral, we'll also add in a plus c. We'll add in a plus c here. So this whole expression is the antiderivative of 3x squared plus 6x minus 7. So something that could have been very difficult if the rule wasn't that simple actually wound up being quite easy, just because we could break it up into, each little individual term here, which made it a lot easier. A couple of other comments with the just to I pulled up a couple other examples just to illustrate some things. This one, integral of x times 2x minus 9, you might look at that and say, oh, well, this is a sum and difference rule because here's a minus sign. Unfortunately, this one is not, because of this product that's going on right here. This really is unfortunate, but there is no integral version really of the product rule. There's something kind of like that that you study in Calc 2 called integration by parts, but no straightforward integration technique for products. Now, we can get around it. We just have to be a little clever, as with most integral problems. We could distribute the x, and then we'd have the integral of 2x squared minus 9x dx. And now it is a sum and difference rule because we just have these two individual terms added or subtracted. Integral of 2x squared would be 2/3 x cubed, right? You increase the exponent by 1 divided by that same quantity, minus 9/2 x squared. We increase x's exponent by 1, you get 2 divided by 2. So we have 9/2 x squared, and then plus c, obviously. All right, now another problem along those same lines, this is a very common mistake as well. See an integral like this, integral of sine 2x minus 1. You see the minus, you say, oh, sum and difference rule. But again, this one's not, because all the expressions are not simply added or subtracted. We have this sign that's encompassing everything. And it would be very bad algebra to try to distribute trig functions. You can't do that. You can't distribute a sine expression to like both of these. So for this one, pretty much stuck. There is a way to do it, and there's a video on this coming up later in the course. But the way you would do this one, I'm not going to do it in this video, is called U substitution. It's an integration technique we use all the time. It's a very common one, but I wouldn't include it in this basic list of like sum and difference rule and the constant multiple rule and the other videos in this little packet of videos. So we're going to skip this one, but just know that this would not be a sum and difference rule.